When all the kings of our history are being remembered for their kingdom, Shah Jahan is the one who's still being remembered for his love. He is the one who gifted the world the symbol of love, Taj Mahal. But unfortunately, the last days of his life were pathetic. This is a story of an emperor who did not have the happy end. Shah Jahan had four sons, Dara Shikoh, Suja, Aurangzeb and Murad. He had an excessive affection towards his elder son Dara Shikoh, so he supported him to be the next emperor. Only Dara Shikoh was staying with his father in the palace. The other three sons were in different regions as governors. It was all fine until Shah Jahan got sick in September 1657. When the other three brothers came to know about this, they suspected that their father had really died and the news had been suppressed by their elder brother Dara Shikoh. Both Shuja, the second son, and Murad, the last son, announced themselves as emperors and marched towards the empire. But on arriving near Banaras, Shuja was defeated by Dara Shikoh's son Suleiman Shikoh. Murad made an alliance with Aurangzeb to conquer the empire from their elder brother. As they expected, Dara Shikoh got defeated, he escaped from the battlefield. After successfully capturing the fort, Aurangzeb killed Murad and became the sole emperor of Hindustan. Later, Dara Shikoh was also captured and beheaded by Aurangzeb. Since Shah Jahan supported Dara Shikoh to be the next emperor against Aurangzeb, he had to suffer the most heartless treatment. Both Shah Jahan and his daughter Jahanara were arrested and imprisoned in the Agra fort. As a punishment, Aurangzeb stopped the water supply of Agra fort from the Jamuna Nadi. Out of extreme thirst, Shah Jahan was forced to drink the brackish salted water from the wells within the fort. About this, he wrote a letter to Aurangzeb in a pathetic tone, "Praise to be Hindus in all cases as they ever offer water to their dead. As though my son art a marvelous Musliman, as though causes me in life to lament for water." Which means Hindus offer water even to dead people. But you, my son, a marvelous Musliman, are making me cry for water. He was treated like a common prisoner and was denied even the common conveniences. Aurangzeb turned a deaf ear to all the requests of Shah Jahan. He spent his last 8 years gazing out the window at the Taj Mahal. At last, like a child that cries itself to sleep, he stopped complaining. He found solace in religion and spent his last days in prayer and meditation. Eventually, he died at the age of 74 on 22nd January 1666, which relieved him from all his miseries. His daughter Jahanara, who was very affectionate towards him, planned a grand funeral which includes a parade of Shah Jahan's body carried by the noble persons of the court, followed by the notable citizens of Agra and officials scattering coins to the poor and needy. But Aurangzeb refused to hold such grand funeral. Finally, the body was taken to Taj Mahal and was buried there next to the body of his beloved wife Mumtaz. Shah Jahan's time is being considered the golden period of Mughal dynasty for architecture. But it's saddening to know that he did not have a happy ending. He lived to witness the killing of two of his sons by his own son, the worst thing that could ever happen to a father. In spite of being an emperor, he was imprisoned by his own son. He spent his last days as a prisoner, living as if life was hell for him.